guys, this is going to be another special video, and I'm moving my mic. Hopefully this isn't coming across as a wild sound here, but this is going to be another special video. This one is really special. It's like a golden nugget that I found. Major League Baseball 2K5 World Series Edition has lots of Easter eggs, some of which I've discovered and some of them I'm on a quest to discover. I'm going to show you, this is going to be like a Quentin Tarantino movie. I'm going to show you a little of the beginning, a little of the end, a little of the middle, and then maybe start over from the beginning and show you how I arrived at all these different scenarios. Right now, what I did is I put in another memory card because I've saved all that other information that I'm babbling about that you don't really understand yet. But there are secret teams, secret uniforms, secret stadiums, all within this game. So, what I'm going to do is show you how to get there. It's not a simple deal. Okay? First of all, you have to create these profiles. Now, each one is accompanied, when you acquire it, with a message from the Take-Two people, Take-Two Interactive and Kush Games. And it's almost like they're teasing you. It's almost like they know they're getting ready to put you through a ringer, so to speak. But you don't know it yet. Because most cheats, once you enter cheats, they pop up, they enhance whatever you want to do, and it saves you a lot of time. These cheats, you got to work for. I mean, work. And I'll show you what I mean. We're going to create a profile. Now, this is actually a code. Okay? This is the first one that I created that I was successful with. Like I said, this is going to be like a Quentin Tarantino movie. I'm going to go back and forth. And I'm going to show you, once I create this profile and show you all the empty slots and whatever, I'm going to show you the one that I've created that's full. Okay? So the first thing you want to type in is old timers. But you got to be, this is all case specific. So you have to be very careful how you type it in. You can't just type in all caps. You got to do lowercase, uppercase, and all that. And you must be precise in how you type it in. You got to put the space in, which I just did. Then I got to go lock the caps again, put the T in, unlock the caps again, and put in timer. I'm just double checking my notes here. I've been doing this for almost, you guys are going to say, he's crazy. I've been doing this for almost 24 hours straight. Okay? So, that should also pique your interest. Why would a person do that? Because I know it's a payoff. I'll tell you how I learned that lesson. There's a game called Fight Night Champion. And the real object of the of that game is to beat Isaac Frost. And you just see it, the internet littered with people saying, oh, this game is unbeatable. You can't beat this game. It's nothing I do. Everything I do, every time I touch the guy, he knocks me out. You got to follow the directions. And sometimes we hear one thing when the directions are telling us another thing. So it's very important that you listen to what I'm saying as well as watch what I'm doing. Now I'm getting ready to enter this. And when I enter this, we should see some kind of message from Kush Games, Take Two Interactive. Okay? Let's see. See it? You just entered in the code to unlock classic teams. Way to cheat the game. You can now play as any of the classic teams that Major League Baseball 2K5 World Series Edition has to offer. That's a cryptic message. First of all, it's saying you can only play with the teams that are offered. If this is a PlayStation 2 game, when I entered this game, I had already had all of the classic teams. So this is kind of an oxymoron where it said old timers and then you can play with all of the teams. But there are other teams. You'll get so frustrated that you say, oh, forget this. You have to be shown things and then you say, oh. Okay? So now we're going to enter in here. And I put in my favorite team, which is the White Sox. And I got to create a new save. So this is going to be a new profile. I'm going to take you around. Okay, it says you successfully did it. I go into the game. By the way, I turned down the sound because you can have all kind of things saved, including settings, and the music just pops up in this game at any time. So in order to stay away from the copyright infringement stuff, there's no sound in the game, but there is sound in the game. When you're doing this, you'll hear it. But I don't need that to interfere with me trying to show you what I'm trying to show you. Now you see this thing here, it says Skybox. When you hit on skyboxes, it's only one skybox that shows, right? You see that, right? Okay. Now, I'm going to show you in the first skybox about the teams already being there. And I'm pressing the right crosshair until I get to this wall here, then I push up. And then once I get to the wall and you see the green flashing there, you push X. And look, these are all the teams that are in the game, supposedly. Not true. Okay? These games come preloaded. I mean, these teams come preloaded. Like I said, I've been up for almost 24 hours, so there will be a few slip-ups here. Sorry about that. I'm drinking coffee. I'm doing everything. See, I'm really a big baseball fan. And any game that has baseball in it and has any codes in it, I always break it. I've done it with every game I've ever had. I'm just getting around to this game because MVP baseball is the best. MLB, the show, is great. This game was like kind of a side game. I bought it because I could. It was real cheap. But now I'm intrigued by it because there's so many layers to it. Okay, so now you go all down the wall. If you want to go down the wall, you have to push R1. That's if you have a PlayStation 2. Xbox, I'm sure it's a similar setup. And I'm pushing it, and nothing's happening. So let's see what's going on with that. Can't move left, can't move right. You hear me? Pressing it. Okay, so let me go back. See, I don't have no tokens. Zero tokens doesn't allow movement. You don't have those tokens, you can't move. Okay? You can see, available tokens, zero. Required tokens. But it already says, you own this item. All this stuff is very cryptic. So you have to pay attention or you'll get lost because you'll get frustrated. Okay? So, see, it says you already own it. So I go back. And then if you look up, you see all those trophy cases up there, up the stairway. That's where we're trying to get to. And I'm pushing it, you hear? Nothing. Okay, now, through the magic of editing, I'm going to show you how this looks once you purchase all this stuff. Then I'm going to show you how to purchase all this stuff. I'm sorry, like I said, this is the only way to explain it fully, is to kind of jump around. So, through the magic of editing, hold on. I want you guys to hear something. It's really not part of this. It's just, it'll help you understand a little bit about me. I'm 66 years old. I live in a retirement facility, which I call the Shady Rest Hotel, which is in Hootersville. And I'll tell you about Hootersville in a minute. But I want this situation to occur so that I'll be authentic to you. Okay? So, check it out. Come in.
Senor.
Senor, how are you, my friend?
How are you?
I'm hanging in there. How about you, amigo?
Okay, good.
You doing good?
Yeah.
It's Friday, right?
Yeah, it's
Friday. That make it real good.
It's Friday, payday.
There you go.
Yeah, good.
Money in the pocket.
Yeah, bye.
All right, you have a good day.
Yeah, you too. Okay.
So, now you know that I'm authentic now. I am who I say I am. I didn't have to do that, but I wanted to do that. Now, back to where we were going as I was getting ready to replace the video. Okay, so that's what I'm going to do. Okay, I'm taking you behind the curtain here. This is where you get all your browser information and you set up your memory card and all that kind of stuff on a PlayStation 2. What I'm doing now is I've already loaded the memory card that has the information that I want to show you. Now I'm going to load the game. Sometimes the games don't load. The laser doesn't read it or whatever. So I'm hoping that it'll perform well now since I'm making a live video. It did. Sometimes it takes me 15 minutes before I get this to work. So now I'm going in. And remember, old timers is my profile, right? That I was showing you guys. I'm going to show you what it looks like when you can complete it. So you'll know from the get-go in this video that it's possible. Okay? Possible to do what you think is impossible. And that is to accumulate and buy things using codes. They call them cheat codes, but they're just developers' codes, so that when these guys are making these games, they can move in and out of areas quicker. Touch up this, touch up that. And they leave these Easter eggs sometimes in the games so that it gives the user something intriguing to pursue. Okay? Some of them are phantoms. Some of them don't even work. Okay? This works. And the only way that you'll know that is me showing you. I'm skipping the beginning of it. Okay? It's going to tell you, it's going to load my profile. See? Old timers, this is not the one I was just showing you guys. This is the real deal Holyfield here. And you'll know because when I go in here and hit start, I'm going to go to Skybox. I don't know if, now you see Skybox, where those other two were redacted before, now they're showing up. What's that all about? Well, when you accumulate enough tokens, you can buy those other two Skyboxes. Okay, you have to go back to the beginning of the video, rewind, whatever, just to, so you'll understand again what I'm showing you was not there before. Okay, so now I'm going in, and this is going to be part one. This video series is going to be long. Now, when you go into the Skybox, the screen goes black for a minute, and then it loads. Okay, remember how this looked. When I went over there and I couldn't move, I couldn't go up the stairs. Now I'm going to be able to go all the way up the stairs. Okay? I keep pivoting to the right. And you see the trophy case there. And I go over. And I select. Now, so I won't be too redundant. I already have all these teams. Now, remember I was trying to hit R1. To move to the right, watch this. This is what happens when you get enough tokens where you can buy everything. Okay. The cheat code that I got said at least try to get 25,000 tokens. Let me look at my notes. Right now I'm up to 66,990 tokens. And that's not counting, excuse me, the 25,000 tokens it took me to get all this stuff, which I'm getting ready to show you. Okay? So these are all the old fields and dot, 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 air hockey, darts, dot, dot, dot. Then move on up the line. Big head. We go to the top. First to 10, these are all codes that'll help you accumulate tokens, okay? That's all this is. And we move up, and these are things to enhance your pitching and whatnot, okay? Performance. And we go up again, and look, these are uniforms. Throwback uniforms. You can't get these unless you purchase, you get enough tokens. Here, let me show you. Some of this stuff is really expensive and some of it's not. Like this is 500. That's nothing. As you can see, you own this item. That means I bought it already, okay? Sonic Blast, that's 500. Thunder, 500. Around the Horn, double play, add extra runs, the fielding team score. This cost 2,000 tokens. You see, I wasn't lying about my actual worth as far as tokens go. It's 66,000. That's how many I got now. You only need like 25,000 to accumulate all these things I'm showing you. Okay? So I'm not going to bore you with showing you all of this, but, you know, I'll do it as quick as I can, and you can go back and slow it down and whatever if you want to. Okay, now we're going to go to this. More uniforms. These are the teams. Okay. More uniforms. These are the teams. Okay, I was able to buy some of these, and I guess I showed you, but I went too fast for myself, but let me do this again. I didn't want to go there. I want to go back down, back down, back down, back down. These are the stadiums that I bought. Sportsman's Park, Ebbets Field, Olympic Stadium, where the Montreal Expos used to play. Then this is where you buy the skybox, like I told you. Okay? Now, see, let me show you what some of this stuff is worth. Okay, Ebbets Field is $1,000. I mean, 1,000 tokens. Sportsman's Park, same thing. So all the ballparks are 1,000. And what this means is you can actually play in these places. Now the skybox, that costs 500. It's pretty cheap for a skybox, I think. Skybox 3, the same, no, it's 1,000. And there's a reason why one costs more than the other. I'll show you that as we go along too. I just want to show you the possibilities before I actually show you how to get all this stuff, okay? Because you say, what's the payoff? You say it's going to do this. I don't want to be around here watching this video for 2 or 3 hours and blah, blah, blah. Well, see, some videos are like that. This is like a stream. Look at this as a stream, something that's being streamed to you right now. And streams can usually last 3 to 4 hours. Okay, but I'm going to break it up into part one or episode one, episode two, part two, whatever, like that. That's what I'm going to do. But I wanted to show you that. Okay, now I'm going to go back out. I'm going to go out again. And then I'm going to show you. This is the part that I don't get yet. This is Hall of Fame. And if you can see all those trophy cases, all those plaques on the wall back there, they're empty. So that means there's something that I have to unlock to get this stuff. You see, I got 66,000 points. I could buy anything. But apparently, this is something you got to earn through gameplay. Okay? Hall of Fame stuff. And there's more than one section. I'll go out and I'll show you. This is the north section. This is the south section. Nothing, nothing, nothing. But now we're going to keep, I'm going to show you. There's more stuff now. This ain't the end of the road. See this wall over here? These are all the trophies that I've won. We're going to go up. Pennant. World Series title. Rookie of the Year. Cy Young. Remember I said I've been doing this for almost 24 hours straight. So I know you, a lot of you don't have the time to do that. That's why I'm showing you what's possible. This game is not impossible. Okay? full of stuff. You just got to get to it. You have to earn all these. You can't just get them. Okay? I'm going to show you how you earn tokens. But I want to show you what you can do before I do that. You know what I'm saying? Now I'm going to take you to the other skyboxes, and then I'm going to show you how to do this. It doesn't make sense to you guys unless I show you all this stuff. I know you say, come on, man, get to the point. Whatever. You young people are especially very impatient. Gotta have learn to have patience. Okay, let's see what Skybox 2 looks like. What's in there? Like I said, this is an enigma. This is like a maze. You have to work your way through all this stuff, and then you figure out as you're going what's it all about. And you see it says trophy room. So let's go up there. Okay. And it basically is the same thing as you saw in the first skybox, the titles that I won. World Series title, Cy Young, most valuable player. Some of these are different. Silver Slugger. This is what the Hall of Fame will look like. Once it's filled in, these pictures will be in there. Now, something over here that didn't get filled in. You see it? As I'm moving to the right, this case, there's a case right there in between. I don't know what it is, but it ain't filled. Player's Choice Award, pennant, Rookie of the Year. So that's it for that. I back out. Go down the stairs here. Hall of Fame North. As you can see, there's nothing there. Look at the empty walls. These all can be filled in. I have to figure out how to do that. And you'll go on the journey with me as I discover this stuff. I'm a baseball fanatic, okay? So I know the payoff is there. I did it with MVP baseball. I got over 10 million profile points, I think it was. And then the counter stopped. And I had everything, you know, all the old ballparks, all the old uniforms. All of that. Ten or 12 World Series titles. All that stuff. Okay? So it is possible. It just looks impossible when you first start. Now, this is for a baseball enthusiast. It really isn't for the average fan, so to speak. And that's another Hall of Fame. It's the same thing. This here, avoid this. This doesn't work. Pictures of what? I don't know. Don't even mess with it. It makes the game freeze, okay? I warned you. Some of you are going to get curious. Just make sure you've saved all your work before you enter into this area. Pictures. Remember, stay away from it until you've saved everything. Then you can come back and the game can freeze up. And all that, and then you can have to reload. Just take my word for it. Now something's up there, TV room. That shows you all it does is show you the intro video. That's it. Ain't nothing else up there. Now this is the game room. This is interesting. I have no idea what this is. One day when I get some time, I'm just going to spend the whole day here. But let me show you right quick. It's loading. It's the silliest thing. I'm supposed to press start. Okay. man, this is how this works. And I got a little better at it. The thing was scoring on me every time. I didn't know what to do. I almost scored on myself. See? Okay. I'm not going to embarrass myself. So I'm going to go out of this, because you can get caught up in a game like this where it's frustrating. It's you actually feel like you're on ice when you're doing it. Okay, so I'm going to exit. Okay. And let's go. Okay, there's the dartboard. I thought this was kind of stupid, too. I don't get it. But I'm sure it means something. It's like, for those of you who played The Matrix, everything in The Matrix, Enter the Matrix and The Path of Neo means something. No, I don't want two players. Start with one play, blah, blah, blah. It's so stupid. I'll try it. You gotta stop that. Try and get it in the bullseye, and then, or near the bullseye. See, now I can do this with the L3 lever, and then when I want to throw it, I go forward and I hit X, and it tells me where it landed. Okay, that's enough of that. Just wanted to show you this stuff is real, okay? When it says game room and all that. Okay? Now, what it means, I don't even know. I'm being honest. This is trivia questions. It's going to ask you a bunch of baseball trivia. So if you're good at it, it's fun. Fun to me, you might not. To the average guy who doesn't like baseball, most of the people don't like baseball now because they say it's too boring. But people who've played the sport, this is really a fun thing to do as a trivia. Because it stumped me a bunch of times, and then I won points back and forth. So this is, but all means something, and I haven't figured out what yet. Okay, just being honest, there's no instructions for this stuff. They want you to be wandering in the dark a certain kind of way, okay? So I think I showed you everything in this room. Yeah, I showed you the trophy rooms. Okay, so we're gonna exit that. And I'm gonna show you the third sky box, and that'll be it. And a lot of you say, come on, man. Well, how am I going to show you how to get stuff? Imaginary stuff that I haven't even told you about or showed you. That means you lose interest right away. I'm just showing you this stuff is real. A lot of times cheat codes are fake and you can't use them, blah, blah, blah. Okay? That's not true with this game. But they're very layered, and they don't let you get them easily, okay? Now, rack your brain while I'm doing all of this, and you tell me, how would you go about it? Okay, now as we go up in this room, basically, this is everything I bought in Skybox 1. So if I go over here, there's all the teams that I've accumulated so thus far. And to be honest with you, they're already in the game. So that's a mind game they're playing with you. Because there's going to be, and then air hockey and all that kind of stuff. Now, here are all the uniforms and the stadiums. from the stadiums, Ebbets Field, Sportsman's, Olympic, and Skybox 3, wore uniforms, went up to the top again. So, it's moving, keep it moving. I'm just showing you. Okay, this room means something, but I don't know what yet. Okay, so now, I'm trying to see. That's it, and we're back out of there. You can see the game room straight ahead. I'm not going in there. Stay away from user stats. That's nothing till you physically play some games. Another Hall of Fame section here that's not occupied. And you got to ask yourself why. Meaning, there are things to be put here. How do you get those things? There's no roadmap for this. You have to figure it out. Just like I figured out how to get the skyboxes, I figured out how to get the uniforms, I figured out how to get the old stadiums. You have to figure it out. They're not going to tell you. They'll let you get in the door, that's all. Okay. So now that's it. I'm going to back out. We're already up to almost 40 minutes on this video. Well, I'm going to back out, and then I'm going to show you something. How you get to all of this. How you get to the point where you can get all this stuff. And that'll be the end of the first part. You should be intrigued if you're a baseball guy. You should be intrigued by now. I may not be the greatest orator around, but I think I can make it understandable. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go out and I'm going to load because I'm in exhibition mode now. I'm not in franchise or career GM, GM career or whatever. So I'm going to load. And when you load with a PS2, it takes time. Okay, first thing I'm going to load is I'm going to reload Old Timers, which is the user profile. I just do it because sometimes PlayStation 2s don't, or they'll kick you out of your profile, put you into another profile. That's why a lot of games get harder as you play them in PS2, because sometimes there's time sensitive. You don't do things in quick enough manner, they boot you back to the beginning. So in order to not have that happen, and this is how I avoid having sound, but yet, even though I do that, the sound will pop back up. That's why I'm leaving it muted while I'm doing this video. You'll see all of that or hear all of that when you go try this. Now this is the very important part. Rosters. And why is that important? Because here's the deal, guys. I'm getting ready to show you some stuff that you didn't know about. Go up under options. Manage rosters. Team rosters. Now, up at the very top right hand, you want to use R2 and put it where it has the pitcher throwing the ball there. Okay? Because what that does is bring up overall ratings. Okay, so you can see the overall ratings. You have to create a team where everybody is 100. Their rating is 100. Huh? That's what you're saying, right? Well, I'm going to show you. Because I've already done it, I can go to the team. There they are. You see? Everybody on this team is 100. Okay? Now, how do you do that? Okay, let's go in where it says edit players. This is just your main, you know, who he is and blah, blah, blah. You want to hit R1 till you move over to this section. You build up everything, chest, midsection, upper arms, forearms, thighs. Everything's got to be maxed. As you can see, everything is maxed. Okay, you go to the next section, everything's maxed. You have to do this manually. Okay, I told you, once again, I'm not bragging on this. I've been doing this for almost 24 hours, okay? I had to figure a lot of this stuff out on myself. Now, on this, everything is maxed out except strikeouts. You don't want to max out his strikeouts because that means he'll strike out 100% of the time. So you always knock that down to 1. Okay? That's on pitchers and everybody who bats. Never, ever go up to 100 on the strikeouts. So they strike out all the time. It'll defeat the purpose of you accumulating tokens quickly. Okay, so now we'll move along. I'm trying to do this quick. You see, everything's 100. Walks allowed. This is a pitcher. Okay, now I discovered this by accident. I would have thought that you want the batters that are facing you to have the lowest average possible. But watch what happens when I lower this. And it lowers in threes. Okay. Go down to doubles. This is what you would want. You would want the fewest amount of hits, right? So you have to remember this. Really what you want to do, you don't want to do this. But I'm going to show you because you're from Missouri. Okay, so now it says finish creative player, and I hit it. Yes. Now watch. See, his rating dropped from 100. Everybody under him is 100. See it? Okay. I dropped my controller. Told you there'd be some bumps along the way since I haven't gotten much sleep. Okay, so now you want to go back in on this player. And you want to go back to that section. And you'll know it because it'll look stranger than the rest of them. See, that's it. So now, walks allowed, you have that 1. But everything else, you got to max it to 100. This is very important when you're doing pitchers. Okay? When you're doing pitchers, people who throw the ball, for the novice, I said that. I know you guys know what a pitcher is. Okay. Now, I'm going to finish and say, watch his rating go back up. Trial and error. That's how I found out about that. Okay? So, that's how you max out everybody. Now, if I wanted to do a batter, let's do a batter. I hit O. You go to batters. And this guy, the shortstop, you'll see his is different than the pitcher. Same thing here. Everything's max. Except for the strikeouts. And see how quick that we finished that? Whereas a pitcher, he has more attributes that you have to deal with. Batters don't. Let's look at it again, in case you missed it. Hitting. No, the first one is going to be appearance. Hitting. Batter fundamentals. Batter fundamentals is where you have to set strikeouts to one. Got to remember that. That's very important. You might have to rewatch the video over and over to get this. Good thing you can speed them up, fast forward them, rewind them. Okay, so now, pause them and all that. Fielding. And fielding is the last one. Then you go back and you hit finish. And you see, everybody's 100. Right? Okay, so now, once you've done everybody, and I'm being very honest with you, to do all of these people, including the minor league guys, on pitching and hitting, it took me about 4 hours. But that's because I didn't know what you know now. Especially with the pitching. Everything is maxed out except strikeouts. Okay? You got to do that. Otherwise, it won't come up 100. If you don't, when you go back to this window and you see overall and it's not 100, you did something wrong. And you have to figure it out. I can't hold your hand on all of it. But I told you the basics. Max everything out except for those sections. You know, where strikeout appears. Like I said, rewatch the video because it'll explain it again. It's wasting time. So now you're going to go out and you're going to say, I have to save that roster again, because if I don't, I could have some errors in there. Okay? You save it under this file. And that's it. Okay, that's going to be the end of part one. I'm trying to be, for some of you who don't have any patience at all, and I know how that is, because some of you, time is money for you. And money is time. I get it. But some things, unfortunately, take a lot of time to do. This is a game I really would love to dabble with, but I got a YouTube channel, so I got to maintain that. And as you can see, it takes a long time to save on a PlayStation 2. On every other system, it's almost instantaneous. PlayStation 2, it's and you can't go on until you don't want to abort this, thinking that it's frozen. It's not frozen. Takes a while, and then it'll pop up. See? There it goes. So don't make that mistake and think, oh, the game even froze on me. No. This is for people who are not familiar with PlayStation 2s. PlayStation 2 guys, y'all know all this. This is for novice people who just got one. Okay? So you hit OK, and you go out. And you go back, and you'll know that everything is copacetic, which means okay, by going to the, if you really want to know, skybox, and you see all, everything is still intact. Remember, originally, when this video started, 2 and 3 were redacted. That means they were shaded, dark. They weren't white. Okay, so you will have to watch the video again at the beginning. You can, the magic of the YouTube video player, you can do a lot of things. Go back and forward fast. You can pause, all kinds of things. But this is a learning video. So you want to learn, you're going to have to watch it more than once. Because it's a lot to digest. Okay? So, a quick review. You have to create this profile, a special profile called Old Timers. That's old, the word, uppercase O, everything else lowercase, old, timer, capital T, everything else lowercase. Okay, very important. You got to do everything. It's all sensitive. You know, sensitive. So, that's the end of part one. You see the possibilities. I'm not just stringing you along. You can go to your game now. You can't access the things I just showed you unless you do these tricks. Okay? Now, to each person, it's worth something. I like the old-time uniforms, all the different variations throughout the years of uniforms and stuff. I like playing in old stadiums, the nuances of them. The corner, some stadiums are real short porches. Some have huge center fields, like, you know, 500 almost feet straight to center field and all that kind of stuff. I love it because it makes you build your team according to whatever your stadium is that your home team plays in. So that's baseball. Baseball guys know what I'm talking about. That's the end of part one. I appreciate you guys watching this. And stay tuned for part two. If I can stay awake, I've been up almost 24 hours straight. Okay, guys? Thanks a lot. Hope you enjoy this. And this is for the baseball guy. If you're not a baseball guy, you're not going to enjoy this video. It's going to be boring. Boring. But if you're a baseball guy, this is something you need to know. Get this game. It's cheap. Get it at Amazon or get it on eBay. Get this game because it's got some gems in it for baseball people. I played baseball all my life. All right. Take care, guys. Part two coming soon.